occupational therapy test observation scale OTOS. First is the introduction of OTOS. The occupational therapy test observation scale is a simple rating instrument. Field usage found that improvements in cognitive capability were successfully monitored by the scale and covered most aspects of patients' activity assessed during task group. Preliminary results show that OTOS provides a reliable and valid tool for rapidly evaluating the role of mental condition patients involved in task group. Next is the developers of OTOS. There are four authors that developed this assessment, which are Russell L. Margolis, Sharon A. Harrison, Hilary G. Robinson, and Gita Jayaram. Next is the purpose and the type of this assessment. The purpose of this assessment is to simplify evaluation and documentation of patient performance during task groups in occupational therapy. The next one is to enhance the interaction between occupational therapists and other members of the care team. The type of this assessment is clinician-rated assessment. Next is the components being assessed in OTOS. There are two parts being assessed, which are task behavior and general behavior. For task behavior, it consists of 10 items, which are engagement, coordination, follows direction, quality of work, independence, initiative, decision making, concentration, frustration tolerance, and problem solving. For general behavior, which consists of 5 items, it assesses the appearance, activity level, expression, cooperation, and socialization. Next is the target populations and the administration time for OTOS. OTOS was developed to be used in intervention and treatment for all clients with mental illness during acute hospitalization. Next, for contraindication, are patients with severe mental disorder and not stable. And for the administration time, is in 15 to 30 minutes. Next is the administration procedure to use OTOS. Firstly, this assessment is a clinician-rated assessment. The therapist will ask the clients to involve in a task group that they will assign to the patients, and she or he will observe the client throughout the session. Next, the therapist will rate client using like a scale from 0, which indicates dysfunctional, to 10, which indicates functional. And lastly, the therapist will calculate the score from his or her observation toward the client. Now, let's look for the administration demonstration in using OTOS.
Assalamualaikum.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
My name is Rashida and I'm your therapist for today. First of all, for today, I would like to evaluate your performance during involved in task group. So, I will assign to you and your group members a task that you will complete it together. And then the task is simple, but I want to see how you involve and interact with your group members during completing the task. Okay, let's get started. Okay, now I want you to make sandwich together. Each of you will make one sandwich. Next is the scoring procedure of OTOS. Each part in OTOS is scored from 0 to 100, which is all 15 items in the scale is rated from 0 to 10, which 0 indicates dysfunctional or maximal dysfunction, while 10 indicates functional or no evidence of dysfunction. Then for part 1, which has 10 items, therapists need to add all scores, while for part 2, which has 5 items, the therapist also need to add all scores, but after that need to multiply by 2. To find final scoring, therapists need to add both scores from part 1 and part 2. Now let's look the way to do the scoring for OTOS. And then for the interpretation of OTOS, The total scores can range from 0 to 100 for each part, with lower scores indicate that the patient is unable to deal adequately during involved in task group.
From my observation, for task behavior, you got 78 over 100, which all items being assessed, you got around 7 to 9 scores over 10, which indicates that you managed to do the task with a good behavior, such as you are able to engage and concentrate when doing the task, and then you are able to tolerate with frustration, as I can see that you were able to be patient while waiting for your turn to put the something on your plate. Next, I also can see that you are independent while doing the task. And then for general behavior, you got 68 over 100. From my observation, I can see that your appearance is very neat and your activity level while doing while making the sandwich is very good. But for expression, you don't express happy or good expression during doing the task. But your cooperation while making the sandwich with the group members is good. Because I can see that you are able to pass up the plate to your group members. And lastly, for socialization, I noticed that you don't talk anything with each other in the group. So I rate you 4 over 10. So the total marks that you got is 146, which I score indicates that you are able to deal adequately during involved in task group. Thank you for today. Let's meet in the next session.
Next is the validity of autos. First is construct validity, which consists of convergent and discriminant validity. For convergent validity, autos scores were highly correlated with scores of all the comprehensive occupational therapy evaluation scale (COTS). The highest correlation between autos task behavior and COTS task scores was 0.88, indicate very strong correlation, while the score for autos general behavior and COTS task scores was 0.592, which indicate moderate correlation. The correlation of the total scores of the two scales was 0.826, which indicate very strong correlation. The high correlation scores between autos and COTS is because COTS was also intended to rate function during task group. And then for the discriminant validity, no evidence is found. Next, for content validity, which consists of phase and representative validity. For phase validity was evaluated through the routine use of autos by occupational therapists working with various patients' populations admitted at Johns Hopkins Hospital. And then for the representative validity, no evidence is found. And lastly, for the criterion validity, also no evidence is found. Then for the reliability of autos. Reliability consists of internal consistency, test retest, and inter-retest reliability. Both for internal consistency and test retest reliability, no evidence found. And for inter-retest reliability, correlation coefficients were 0.89 for test behavior scores, 0.76 for general behavior scores, and 0.92 for the total scores. Now let's look at the advantages and disadvantages of autos. Firstly, for advantages of autos, this assessment requires minimal training, takes a short amount of time to complete this assessment, and lastly, the final scoring is easy to calculate. For disadvantages, firstly is lack of studies on autos, secondly is no cut-off score, and lastly no specific interpretation to interpret the score. Lastly, the suitability to be used with Malaysian population. Autos is suitable to be used with Malaysian population because the items contained in this assessment does not relate with any culture or religion. That's all for autos. Thank you for your attention.